painting is a wonderful, wonderful activity, and you cannot believe how inspiring it can be if you take up a brush and have a go. And don't worry about trying to be an artist, just paint. That when you're painting, there is sometimes you feel you're striking certainty. There's a certainty sometimes that comes from somewhere else. It's a different sort of way of feeling the world and thinking about and thinking things through, because you're not doing it rationally. When you're painting, the action and the movement of doing it is the thinking. Here's an example, right? I thought of George, and I was thinking of the gesture of looking down on his head. So you've got here a head looking down, but you've got a face which has no psychological presence. I then said, well, yes, I want his eyes to be looking up. So already here you have a stronger psychological impact than you do with that one. And then I move on to these, if you like, more expressionistic, because yes, I want his eyes looking up, and then I want his head looking down. So, and as I was drawing with my black, you know, paint and stuff, there was a certainty. There was an authority that I saw when I had made my marks, that I could say yes. Each time you're working, you're trying to find a point of recognition of when you can say, that is true, that rings true. What I love about painting is it comes onto your system, instantly, you know? It's like, you know, getting an electric charge, and while you've got a good painting in front of you, you know, and I think for me, you know, when I have turned a painting around and around and around and worked on it, and finally put it on the wall, if it gives me that moment of charge, then I feel I've, you know, done the business. You know, much of the traditional portraiture that I have seen and sort of grew up with, I very much rejected it because I didn't feel it had the emotional content that I wanted in a painting. I left art school at 24. Maybe when I was about 26 or 27, I was doing a portrait of myself. I just remember, you know, looking at myself in the mirror and putting these marks down, and I just felt, I'm gonna burst, I'm just gonna scream, I can't bear this any longer. And I just got the brush and went, you know, all over it.
Because I turned 60 the other day, I thought I ought to, you know,
Oh, cool.
And then this one here in my hat,
I just couldn't do it anymore. And that was the start of me kind of, you know, breaking out.
I sometimes like really sort of crude, rough, cheap brushes like these. You know, there's an aspect of that kind of rough edge that I like about my painting generally. I tend not to go for the fine art craft aspect, you know, and I work on hardboard as well as canvas. I'm trying to, it's a bit like analysing what I do intuitively, but I just noticed, you see, that sometimes there's a different tempo. Oh yeah, well, I'm responding to the colour and seeing, you know, where it goes.
You know, because it's not like I'm starting off knowing what I want to get, where I want to get to. I'm just journeying, you know, and trusting some deep-rooted sensibility that there's a point of some sort of truthful recognition of something.
The activity of painting for me, it's been to unlock areas where I've been blocked. I kind of feel that in a way, much of what I've painted has had a kind of redemptive quality. You know, it's redeemed my relationships. Painting, it's like a bit like a mirror, I suppose. You know, when people look into it, they will see, you know, whatever they want to see. And that, I mean, and that, I think, you know, I mean, that's the interesting end of it, is what on earth do other people get from it? I mean, you know, for myself,
you know, it's obviously intensely kind of private. You know, art is a necessity. Some people have to, you know, read and eat and do things. I've had to make images. I've had to make images. I just acknowledge how much unbelief I have in me. You know, there are huge parts of me that just do not believe. But I realized, as a sort of long-haul Christian, I have felt it terribly difficult to get to that place where I could acknowledge that amount of doubt and that amount of unbelief. But the funny thing is, since I have abandoned it and admitted that I don't know, I feel far more invaded by the Spirit than I ever did. And to me, that is the most exciting place for me to be at, is this recognition that, you know, that the Spirit of God moves as He will.